Updated 5 November 2017, 1630 AEDT. George Bush Sr. has revealed in a new book that he voted for Hillary Clinton instead of blowhard Donald Trump in last year's US election. Yes, you read that correctly. And that's not all. George W. Bush didn't vote for Mr. Trump either. Here's how we know. A new book is set to be released later this month, in which the two former leaders open up about their relationship. But the book, entitled The Last Republicans and written by historian Mark Upder Grove, also explores how both men feel about the U.S. president. In short, they're not fans. According to the book, George H.W. Bush, who served as president from 1989 to 1993, has an instinctive dislike of Mr. Trump. The 93-year-old reveals he voted for Mrs. Clinton at the 2016 election and describes Mr. Trump as a blowhard driven by ego, who lacks a commitment to public service. Gee, Mr. Bush, tell us how you really feel. And George W. Bush, who served in the White House from 2001 to 2009, reveals he voted for none of the above because he believes the billionaire businessman lacks humility and a necessary understanding of what it means to be president. That's why, according to Hang-Seo, an interview author Upder Grove gave with the New York Times, the younger Bush fears he will turn out to be the last Republican elected president. During the election, I think he was concerned that Hillary Clinton would win, Upder Grove said. But if you look at his values and those shared by his father and Ronald Reagan, they are very much in contrast to the values of the Republican Party today, in particular the platform that Donald Trump ran on, which is essentially protectionism and a certain xenophobia. Is this all new information? Yes, but the Bushes have certainly dropped clues about how they feel towards Mr. Trump in the past. Last month, George W. Bush gave a speech in New York that appeared to be a sweeping, yet thinly veiled critique of the Trump administration, its policies, and the president's blunt style. In it, he denounced bullying and prejudice in government and defended open immigration and trade, two of the pillars of previous Republican administrations that have been attacked by Mr. Trump, but never mentioned Mr. Trump by name. What has the White House said about all this? In a statement, White House spokeswoman Sarah Sanders said the American people voted to elect an outsider who is capable of implementing real, positive, and needed change, instead of a lifelong politician beholden to special interests. If they were interested in continuing decades of costly mistakes, another establishment politician more concerned with putting politics over people would have won, she said. Ab Reuters.